In previous videos, we have looked at both 2D and 3D projection mapping. However, in all of these videos, there was one caveat. We had to either find or create projection content beforehand, and once we loaded it into our system, we could not change it. Today, let's look at some ways that we can generate our own projection content in real time, which also allows us to add some interactability to it. For this project, we are going to use a physical joystick to control the dynamic lighting in a 3D projection design. By moving the joystick around, we also move the corresponding light around, which will cause the shadows and reflections to change on the object. As always, you can find links to the code used and all the parts below in the description if you want to try this for yourself. We can divide this up into four different sections. The first section is the joystick that gets our input. The second section is how we convert an electrical signal from the joystick into something that the computer can understand. The third section is how to create a 3D environment to hold our 3D objects and lights. The fourth and last section is the dynamic control of the 3D projection mapping. Let's start with the joystick. Joysticks are pretty simple input devices. We are probably most familiar with seeing them on electronic devices such as game consoles. The only thing that the joysticks really do is get the X and the Y coordinates from the user. You can push it to the left or right, up and down, or a combination of the two axes to complete the coordinate input. Joysticks usually have four connections that are needed to get the X and Y values. First, we need to connect it to power and ground. Next, there will be two pins that correspond to the X and Y axis. Internally, all a joystick really is a combination of two potentiometers, one for each axis. As we move the joystick, the voltage level will change. For example, if we were to move the joystick all the way to the left, we would see 0 volts. And moving it all the way to the right, we would see 5 volts. We now need to make sense of these raw voltage values and convert them into something that the computer can understand. To do this, we are going to use a device called a microcontroller, which essentially is a very little computer that has many inputs and outputs. The simplest microcontroller to get started with is the Arduino platform. This provides us a very easy way to get into the world of embedded programming. Let's start by connecting our joystick to our Arduino. We want to make the connection shown on screen now. There are two main types of inputs, analog and digital. A digital input only has two states, either on or off, just like a light switch. Since we need to measure the precise voltage from the pins on the joystick, we'll need to use what is called an analog input, which is also known as the ADC, the analog to digital converter. What this does is it takes the voltage level and it maps it to a number. The lower the voltage, the lower the number, and the higher the voltage, the higher the number. We simply need to write a few lines of code that configure the pins as inputs, then read the analog value of X and Y axes. Now that we have the joystick values, we need to find a way to get them from our Arduino device to our computer. Thankfully, there's a protocol called serial that allows us to send data over a USB connection. To initialize a serial connection on our Arduino, we need to call one line of code. First, we need to create a string to send over the serial connection. This will consist of the X value and the Y value separated by a comma and a new line character at the end. Now that the string is ready to go, we just need to call a command to send it. Now we can upload our code to the board and test it to see if it works. Now let's move on to the 3D section. I decided to use Processing, an open source framework for visual arts. It has both a 2D and a 3D rendering engine built right on top of OpenGL, which makes it the perfect choice for creating our own 3D projection mapping sketch. If you are new to 3D projection mapping, check out my previous video that explains the basic concepts. Just like last time, we need a three-dimensional file that matches the object that we are going to be projection mapping onto in the real world. I found a picture design and I 3D printed it out using white PETG. Since the 3D object and model are the exact same, the mapping process will be fairly straightforward. First, we need to create a 3D environment within Processing. Next, we need to import our .obj file. From the last video, we know that all we need to do is align the camera in the scene to the same location where the projector is in the real world. In Processing, we can accomplish this by translating, rotating, and scaling the object with a few lines of code. Since we will need to do this live when setting up I wrote some code that listens to key presses and does it for us. Next, let's add in a point light that we can move around. Now, we need to receive the serial communication from the Arduino. Thankfully, processing has a serial library built right in that we can start using without too much extra configuration. We just need to find the port that the Arduino is connected to, and we can use this by using the Arduino IDE, and hovering over Tools, then Ports. Simply put that into processing and are ready to go. Now in our draw loop, we can listen to the incoming serial packets and parse them by splitting the string at the comma and parsing the resulting values into an integer variable. And that integer variable corresponds to the X and Y coordinates of the point light that we added earlier. Now let's test this out. I place my projector in front of the object and I use my arrow keys that we programmed in earlier to make sure that the camera in the scene matches the projector's output exactly. Now we can move the joystick around and see the lighting change. Neat. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any suggestions for a future video, go ahead and leave it in the comments below. And I will see you next time.